everybody. My name is Tony and I'm here with the Everyday Counts program. Thank you for joining me. You could be doing a million other things and you've chosen to spend a little bit of time just moving and breathing and tuning into yourself. So we have an hour together for chair yoga. And this chair yoga is about you. It's not my class, it's your class. So see if you can give yourself permission to do what it is that feels right to you today. As if you were sitting in the seat of the teacher, so you can give yourself permission to listen to what it is that your body's telling you that is perfect for you. Sitting on a chair that's comfortable and stable, and deciding whether you want to sit into the back of your chair or away from it. All of these choices, know that there's no right or wrong way to do this. This is about simply what feels right to you. And you can change it up at any point. Feet a comfortable distance apart. And then maybe you want to spread those toes wide, even wake them up a little bit, until you lay them all the way down on the surface underneath you. Sending your awareness all the way down into your feet. And just notice, maybe for the first time today, how the soles of your feet are doing. Notice all the places they're connected. And it doesn't matter whether you're wearing bare feet, socks, slippers, shoes. Just notice the experience of the soles of your feet in this moment. You can even imagine, if you like, roots coming out of the soles of your feet, traveling down into the earth and connecting downwards. It might give you a sense of grounding, and it may not. Again, this is all for you to decide. You could allow the weight of your legs to be really supported by the soles of your feet, and notice if there was any muscles tightening or holding any tension to resist that. Travel your awareness up your legs into your seat where you're supported by the chair. And allow your upper body to rest its weight into the chair, into your seat. Notice again the support underneath you, and always asking yourself if there's a more comfortable way to sit. Is there a way you can shift your body any amount for it to feel better for you? And from that connection downwards to the support, we're offering a lifting through the upper realms of our body, up through the crown of the head, as if the very crown of your head was reaching a little closer towards the sky. Notice how that feels for you. And again, if there's anything you can adjust or adapt to feel better for you, we're all put together differently. We all need different things. Your shoulders could soften away from the ears, and you could consider widening across the collarbones just to allow the heart and the chest space to find a little more openness there. Decide whether sitting a little bit back with the shoulders or a little bit forward with the shoulders feels best for you. A lot of the time, bringing the shoulders over the hips can feel like the most comfortable place to be because our bones feel a little more stacked in that place and the muscles have to do a whole lot less. But that may or may not be true for you. You get to decide. When you're ready, take a breath in, all the way to the top of your breath. And exhale it out like a sigh and release tension. Another few breaths like that. And feel free to close your eyes or soften your gaze. And we start to tune out the outside world and start to give ourselves permission to go inwards. After a few soft breaths, when it feels right to you, simply allow your breath to come back to its own easy rhythm. Noticing how you're feeling today. Noticing how your body feels today. Aware of any stories that arise. I'm tired and this and that. Also, stories about sensations. If there's a particular place in your body that's very familiar and loud, or that there's, oh, I slept on that shoulder. Just let all those stories rise up and let them drift away as well, as you simply rest in the awareness of your body. Noticing it all, noticing the tight places, the sensations, but also notice the quiet places, the places that you might even feel ease or strength. And there's a whole bunch of places that you're not going to have any awareness to at all. And we all have that whole gambit of experience within our bodies. Open your awareness up to all of the things that your body is telling you as best as you can. And this is where we get to listen intently. And we'll do that throughout our practice, so we start to tune into the language of the body and the language of our intuition, so we know what's best for us, rather than outsourcing to somebody else what you should be doing. Consider listening to your inner teacher, your body, your intuition, and choosing from there. Breathing in and out through the nose if that's comfortable for you, and if it's not, then find a breath that does feel comfortable. And start to notice the exhales from the top of the exhale all the way down to the bottom of the exhale, the whole exhale. And as we place our awareness on the exhale, it naturally starts to steady the exhale, even lengthen the exhale somewhat. If there's any parts of the exhale that feel super jumpy, then just be aware of that, not needing to change anything. You might even listen to the sound of the exhale. We call this in yoga that sound of the exhale, ujjayi, or commonly known as ocean breath, because if you listen to the sound of your breath coming out all the way to the end of your breath, and it's not a very loud sound, it could sound like the waves coming in and out on the shore of the ocean. It could also sound like the breeze rustling the leaves of a tree, or anything else for you, but I'm going to call it ocean breath. We're going to focus on that exhale. You might even allow that exhale to get one notch louder. Not so you're filling the room with the sound, but just so you can hear it clearly and start to allow yourself to follow the exhale from the top all the way down to the bottom. And as you do that, it will naturally start to smooth out. Ocean exhale. And if ujjayi is a natural practice for you, then you can of course do it on the inhale too. But today I'm just gonna call to focus on that exhale. Ocean exhales. And if at any time it becomes becomes uncomfortable for you or too much, you just let it go and come back to your own natural breath. So with those exhales, those ocean exhales, see if there's any forcing that is involved. And see if you can let that forcing go, even if the breath becomes smaller, even if that sound becomes softer. So it becomes more sustainable. Releasing any tension in your body. And releasing any ideas that there's any right and wrong here. Again, this is about you listening to you rather than me. Listen to me a little bit of the time, but 90% of the time you're listening to yourself and giving yourself the permission to do what it is you need. Rooting down through your feet and seat as we keep this breath. Lengthening maybe through the spine and widening across the collarbones. Ocean exhales. And from here, this is the inhale. On the exhale, ocean exhales. We're going to look all the way over to one side. Inhale back to center. Ocean exhales all the way to the other side. Allow the movement to mirror the steadiness and the length of the inhale and exhale. Ujjayi exhale. The rest of your body is still and steady. The movement really is coming from the collarbones up. And then the two either side. And consider whether you want to stick your chin out a little bit. Notice if that changes things. Back to center, we'll stay there, allowing that right hand to dangle down. If you've got an arm on your chair, you're welcome to have that elbow bent, or release the hand over that arm of the chair. I'm going to start to just wave that arm. What we're looking for is flow. We're looking for softness here. So start at the fingertips, wrists, elbows. Doesn't have to be a big movement. It can simply be beside you. Ocean exhale. So on that exhale, the arm is flowing down to stillness. I highly recommend softening your gaze or lowering your gaze or closing your eyes, having an internal experience. And maybe that arm movement wants to get bigger. Maybe it doesn't. One is not better than the other. This is about listening to your body and noticing what feels best for you. Ease of movement. Allow that exhale, the whole ocean exhale for the arm to rest down. Our tendency is to let that exhale, drop the arm a little quicker than the inhale. As if there's resistance there, as if you're moving through water that you don't want to ripple. We've got another two to go. And this is generally what we want in our daily functional movements, is ease. Allow that arm to come all the way down. Right hand is supported. Left hand comes down, and we start to move just gently. Listen to the sound of the exhale. Allow that exhale movement to be the length of your exhale. Ocean exhale. And from there, eyes soft, lowered, closed is a great way to be. And start to allow that movement. particular way. It doesn't have to be in a particular height or trajectory. Maybe it gets bigger as the body gets used to the movement. Maybe it doesn't. Again, be your own teacher here. Give yourself permission to do what feels best for you. Or play around if you're not quite sure. Put another two here. Listen to the sound of the exhale. And notice if you can blend the movement to that ocean exhale. Bringing the hands back to support. We're going to circle those shoulders in your own way. Hands resting or hands next to you. Inhaling and ocean exhales. Allow every exhale to feel like it releases tension, tightness, even thoughts. Allow your awareness to rest on your experience within that exhale. Let the inhale take care of itself. And then we're going to take those circles through the shoulders, round in the opposite direction. Which is probably going to feel a little awkward. But again, even within our daily functional movements, and there's things that feel awkward, but what we're trying to do is find the flow, find the steadiness within them. Put another three movements here. Rest if you need to. Again, that's part of listening to what it is that you need. Last one. And wherever your hands are, we'll dangle them next to it. I'm going to take that right hand forward and I'm going to mirror you. We're going to take the left hand back. That's the inhale and exhale down. Inhale up in the opposite direction. So making sure you've got space around you for that to happen. Ocean exhale. So that exhale, it's probably going to feel like it's really slow. Give yourself permission to change up the rhythm if you need to, if that feels better for you. Notice where tightness and tension creep into the movement, if at all. We've got another two either side, a little bit like cross-country skiing here. End of the next exhale, we're going to take those hands down and roll through the shoulders somewhat. From here, we're going to take the arms out, elbows soft and towards the ribs, whether they get there or not, it's neither here nor there, palms towards the front. From here, widen through the collarbones, and then consider taking your awareness right in between the shoulder blades, and notice the positioning, notice how you experience the shoulder blades here. And on the inhale, we're just going to draw those shoulder blades in towards each other. So we're going to get this openness across the chest. Notice if you're flaring the front ribs out. If you are, just drawing them in somewhat. So we have a neutral spine. That's the inhale. Exhale, drawing the palms towards each other. Inhaling and exhaling. And you're going to notice if you start to move through the spine or if the movement is through the shoulders. It doesn't have to be a big movement, but we're just opening up through the whole shoulder girdle. On that inhale, imagine the shoulder blades kissing together behind you, and on the exhale, they slide apart. From here, option to add on is to add a hug in there as the shoulder blades slide apart. Inhale, opening up, and opposite arm on top as we hug. Again, not a very big movement, but again, essential for or functional movement. Ocean exhale. Give yourself permission to change up your rhythm if you need to. Again, there's no right or wrong here. Two more full movements. And I'm going to come back with the palms out. This is now the exhale, elbows drawn down. As if you've got a wall behind us, you'd rest the top of your shoulders, the back of your skull, and your pelvis on the wall. Maybe even the back of the hands come towards or even resting on that imaginary wall. Inhale, I'm going to slide those fingers up, keeping the angle in the elbows. Exhale, drawing it down. Once again, this is all in the shoulder blades and the shoulders, inhaling and exhaling. Keeping the spine as neutral as possible. And I know that we like to overarch here, but consider keeping the spine neutral so the movement really is through the shoulders. You might notice some parts of the movement are less smooth than others. You might notice that some places feel really easy. Ocean exhales. We've got another two more here. If you want to rest, then rest. Nicely done. Hands come down as if you've got two big mason jars next to us. Opening and closing the top of those mason jars, twisting them on and off from the shoulders and not just from the wrists. And then from here, option to take opposite hands, wrists, or even elbows, or somewhere in between. We're gonna root to rise, broaden through the collarbones, and lift through the crown. Come back to those ocean exhales, listening to the sound of the exhale. And from here, with that connection in through your hands, wrists, or forearms, I'm going to start to circle. Once again, bringing lubrication in through the shoulders. Spine is as neutral as we can make it to start with. Inhale, lifts it up. Exhale, that ocean exhale, drawing it down. And I know it probably feels really slow, but that is the ability to bring and learn to tune into our awareness here, is within the slow movement of the breath, moving the body to that rhythm. The nervous system loves the body to move with the breath. It's soothing for it. And then we get to tune in and notice, again, listen to the language of your body. Those movements can be bigger or smaller, keeping the spine neutral. And then the add-on here is to start to turn the shoulders naturally with the movement. And we're getting in through the spine here into a gentle circle, gentle twisting. And so allowing the spine to simply move in its own natural way. And within the slowness, especially of that ocean exhale, we get to tune into sensations, decide whether we need to change something up. Give yourself permission to adapt it for your body. We've got another two in this direction. Take the head with you, if that feels good in your neck. At the end of the exhale, coming back to center. Whichever grip you have, opposite arm and hand on top, rooting to rise, coming back to that breath. And then we're going around in the opposite direction, so neutral spine. big or as small as you like. Ocean exhales. Notice what's happening in your body. And then the add-on is allowing the spine to start to softly twist with that movement. The gaze can come with you. Give yourself permission to change this up as you need to. We've got another three to go. And at the end of your last exhale, we'll come back to center, ocean exhales, releasing the arms. Any movement you need that serves you, go ahead. And coming back to center. From here, getting down into the spine a little more. You take the feet a little bit more than hip distance. And then we're going to heel toe those feet over to one side, making sure you feel stable. And if you need to sit back into your chair for that to happen, go ahead. Another thing you could do is put something underneath you, like a bolster, to bring your feet up. That can also help. I'm going to slide to the edge of my chair. So the feet over towards the right, and we're coming on the inner and outer blade of those feet, so there's no need to keep the soles of the feet down unless that serves you. From here, hands onto the thighs, you can support yourself with the chair. On the inhale, we're going to lift up through the heart, draw the front ribs out, maybe even lift the gaze. So we've got extension through the spine here. On the exhale, we're going to roll back, belly in towards the spine. And there's a really good chance you're going to start to feel this around, especially the lower back where the pelvis is, the SI joint. If you've got any SI joint issues, then gentle movement here. It's really good for massaging the SI joint. But we're going through extension and flexion of the spine with the feet off. So we're getting into the hips, into the lower back, and especially into that SI joint here. Only as much or as little movement as feels good. That exhale, still that ocean exhale. And quite often the exhale is where the sensations are getting a little louder, so pay attention to that exhale, only going as far as feels comfortable. And again, you can bring this all the way up to the base of your skull, lifting the chin, exhaling, drawing down. So we get that flexion and extension through the cervical spine too. Notice where it is that you experience this movement. Another few here. Always resting if you need to. Take another movement. If another arises for you in your awareness, you prefer. Staying for the last exhale and coming up to center. Left hand on the chair, right hand thumb to the outside of the thigh, and the fingers rolling over to the top of the thigh or even towards the inside of the thigh. This is the exhale. On the inhale, we're lifting the right hip, gazing over to the left, exhaling back to center. Now this can be a small movement. Doesn't have to be big. And again, we're isolating in, especially through the lower back, the quadratus lumborus, the QL, that connects the top of the iliac crest of our pelvis to the back bottom ribs. It can get very tight as we spend so much time sitting. Got another couple to go. Rest if you want to, making sure your feet are supporting you. That right hip can feel lighter or lift any amount. Coming back to center and heel toeing the feet back to center, rearrange yourself on your chair. Take a breath in and exhale it out. Nicely done. Ocean exhales, come back to that breath. Allow yourself that rest of the exhale to awaken your awareness to everything that's going on. And then when you're ready, we can take those feet over towards the left to a place that you feel comfortable. And this side may feel very different. And again, the option is to have your feet up on a bolster or some kind of firm steadiness. You could take yoga blocks if they're heavy and firm enough. Hands to your chair or to the thigh. On the inhale, we're going to lift up, extension through the spine. Think cat and cow. On the exhale, we're drawing back, sitting maybe onto the back of your pelvis, any amount. Inhaling and exhaling. And if you need to adjust the width of your feet, how far they are off to the left, then that's fantastic. Again, that is part of listening to yourself. Listening to what it is that you need. Take in the experience of your entire spine. Of course, you can lift your chin on the inhale, draw the chin in towards the chest on the exhale. Getting in through your hips, through your SI joint, through the entire undulation of the spine. Your shoulders involved. Another two here. Coming back up to center, right hand supports you on the chair. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're lifting up through the left seat, maybe just twisting back to center. Or you can really lift up through the left hip if you feel stable enough. There's still an extension and flexion going on through the spine, but a lot of this is going on through the hip. Adjust yourself if you need a little bit of extra or less support. Gazing over towards the right, maybe even back behind you, depending on where your stability is. We've got another couple here. And then at the end of the exhale, we're coming back to center. Heel toeing the feet back in. Readjust yourself on the chair so you feel stable. Take a big breath in. Exhale it out. Come back to those ocean exhales. Just check in with yourself. Notice what your body is telling you. Stay here for as long as you like. And then when you're ready, I'm going to meet you down on the floor, keeping everything with you that you need for relaxation at the end. And I'll see you down there. And from being seated on the floor, we'll come all the way down to our back, making sure you have as much softness and support underneath you as you need. So if it feels better for you to have a pillow behind you, then please take that. Knees to the sky, feet to the floor when you're ready. And it might feel comfortable for you to lift up the pelvis, lengthen through the lower back as you place the pelvis further down on the floor. Feet at a comfortable distance. And from here, take a big breath in. Exhale it out. Go ahead, soften your gaze, close your eyes if you're comfortable, and come back to that sensation of being held and supported by the earth underneath you. Allow your body to rest into that support. And start to notice that ocean exhale, the sound of the exhale. And from here, we're gonna draw that right knee in towards your chest. Give it a little hug. Ocean exhale. hands come to a comfortable place, either beside your hips, somewhat palms down, in a T or a cactus. You can even take your hands underneath your skull if that feels okay in your shoulders. From here, a little flex in that right ankle, and then we're going to start cycling with that right leg, one-legged cycling. Listen to the sound of your exhale. Inhaling, the foot comes round and up, and exhaling. Well, it depends actually, you might be going in a different direction. Most people pick in and up, exhaling, out and down. But maybe you're one of those unique people who go in the opposite direction first. There's no right and wrong here. Option to stay here, cycling, but it's slow. The slower we do this, the more we're awake to sensations, the more challenging it actually is in the body as well, the slower we do it. Consider extending that leg a little longer or not. The left foot is supporting you, as is your back body. So noticing what's happening in your pelvis, the upper shoulders. Another two in this direction. And then when you're ready, pause and then go around in the opposite direction. Start small. And again, what we're looking for is fluidity. And we're not looking for perfect. Ocean exhale is guiding the length of the movement. And there might be some places that feel less smooth than others. The option is, of course, to allow that leg to extend a little more, but only if that suits your body. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the next exhale, we're going to draw that knee in, give it a little hug again, and the outer ankle comes to rest on the top of the left thigh, arms come to a comfortable place again. So the further that left heel is away from you, the easier this is going to be in the right hip. The closer you draw it towards your seat, then the more challenging it's going to be. We want the ankle on top of anywhere along the thigh, but the pelvis to be as neutral as possible. So if you're here, if the right hip is really hiked up, consider readjusting that left heel to allow the back of your pelvis to feel neutral. And this may be enough here. Pulsing the right knee down and away from you without shifting the pelvis. So we really are getting into the hip here. If we get the pelvis involved, then we're tweaking into the lower back. It's not necessarily wrong. It's just that I was considering isolating into the hip. So you get to choose what feels right for you. It's just building awareness to what it is that's part of this movement. Option to stay with the knee out, and this may be enough for you, that connection of the outer right ankle, top of the left thigh, breathing those ocean exhales. The option is, of course, thread the needle, drawing that left thigh up and towards the ribs, holding the outer thigh underneath that knee, or threading the arms through to the front of the shin. Both feet are flexed here. Inhaling and exhaling. We've already opened up the hips somewhat when we were doing our cat and cow with the legs off to the side. This is an extension of that. Inhaling and exhaling, breathing into those ocean exhales, allowing that exhale to release tension, tightness through that right hip. And the option is to stay here. The option is to release any connection you have to the left thigh. And then push with the right out to ankle into the left thigh. The left thigh pushes back. You've got dynamic tension there. Left heel can lift up knee height. And then consider that left thigh coming almost reaching up towards the sky. And that's going to change up the sensation, the engagement, especially through the lower abdominals. We're breathing those ocean exhales. If you lose the breath, do a little less. Another three steady breaths here. The pressure on the ankle and the thigh is your choice. It's as much or as little as you want, and of course you can come back to regular thread the needle without the holding. And then from there, we're going to take that left foot down to support and release the right leg. Feet go a little wider, and we're windshield wipering the knees side to side. Same thing, other side. So feet come back to a comfortable distance for you. Left knee draws in, a little flex in that ankle, and we give it a little hug. And that's going to depend on the length of our bones and where it feels comfortable for us. We're all put together differently. You don't have to try and fit your body into something that somebody else is doing. That's where the inner teacher comes in. Arms come into a comfortable place for you. And we're starting to cycle. One-legged cycle with that left leg. So we're getting in through the hip here. It's also the knee, also the ankle. It's also the lower abdominals. And what's going to bring everything together is that ocean exhale. Go inside, notice your breath. Allow that movement to be as big or as small as you like. There's no right and wrong. Tune into that inner teacher, your intuition, what your body's telling you. Use that information to discern what it is that you need to do. And if resting is what you need to do, then listen to that. You can allow that leg to extend as much or as little as you want. Turn this into your movement. And again, we're looking for the flow, which is what we want in our everyday functional movements. We've got another three in this direction. And then when you're ready, we'll pause with the knee drawn in. Take as many breaths as you need to pause. And then we take it round in the opposite direction, which may feel a little less smooth, may not. Notice your experience of it. Ocean exhales. Option to extend that leg a little further. And then when you're ready, that knee comes in, you can give it a little hug. Settle the breath if it was elevated. And when you're ready, keeping that flex in the left ankle, comes over the top of the right thigh. Back body is equally supported, and the option is to adjust that right heel closer or further away to accommodate that left hip. And then we start to pulse, noticing when you pulse the left knee away from you, how it can start to twist the pelvis. So notice if you're getting the spine involved or you're really easing into the movement of the hip, or a little bit of both. Notice which feels right for you. And the option
option is to stay there with that knee out to the side, left ankle flexed. Great place to be. Ocean exhales, listening to the sound of your breath, listening to the language within you. And then the option is thread the needle. The right foot comes up off the floor, holding on to the thigh, back of the knee, in front of that shin, depending on the length of your arms. Both feet have a flex in the ankle here just to support the knee joints. And we breathe. Ocean exhales. Imagine that exhale releasing tension and tightness from the hip. If the breath becomes too labored, then do a little less, take a rest. Come back to something that feels easier for you, a previous modification. And then when you're ready, option to stay here, option to push the thigh away with that left ankle, the thigh comes back into that left ankle. We've got dynamic tension here. Right heel can come up towards the right knee joint, or knee height, I should say. The pressure that you're building up here is as much or as little as you need, so you can completely release that. You can come back to normal, thread the needle, take that right foot down to the floor if you want. But we're breathing here. Consider drawing that right knee up towards the sky a little further. That's gonna activate a few more, especially abdominal muscles. Ocean exhales, always staying within the range of the breath. Got another 3 breaths here. And then when you're ready on the end of that exhale, we'll take the foot all the way down to the floor, that right foot, and release the left ankle. Taking the feet a little further apart, maybe mat distance. Shoulders and the back of your skull are rooted and windshield wiper the knees from side to side. Finding a little openness through the hips. The pelvis feels okay here in the SI joint. Option is just as we did on the chair, lifting up the opposite hip as the knees come a little bit further to the other side. And we get that twist through the spine, gentle twist. You can take the gaze away from the knees, and then that twist is coming up through the base of the skull. Option to stay here, option to take the knees to one side and stay there for 3 breaths, only if the lower back, especially that SI joint, feels like it can stay here sustainably and comfortably with the breath being easy. Ocean exhales, adjusting everything as you need to, that right top knee can be weighted down with the bottom heel if you want. And then when you're ready, gently coming to the other side, releasing the bind on the leg and maybe adding it to the other side. Doesn't feel good in my body, I'm not going to do that. Ocean exhales, listening to the sound of your breath. When you're ready, coming back up to center, drawing your knees in towards you, giving yourself a little hug, rock and roll side to side, front and back. Stay in one place, knees can be together or wide. Listening to the ocean exhales. Can stay here or happy baby, feet can come up towards the sky if you want, knees wide towards the outer ribs. Hands on the thighs, shins to the outer feet, heels up towards the sky, spreading the toes wide, widening through the lower back, the pelvis, the groin, only staying within the breath. Ocean exhales. And then when you're ready, releasing everything down to the earth, you can stay here, constructive rest, knees together, ankles wider in a little tent, or take the legs long. You know what you need here. If you need support underneath the back of your thighs to release the lower back, go ahead. If you want layers, if you want pillows, eye pillows, you get yourself sorted. As I come up to guide you. So there's no right and wrong here. If you have a reclining chair or a bed or a sofa close by and you have a more comfortable place to be, then please go ahead and offer yourself that. Settling into your comfort. Haven't already, option is to go ahead and close your eyes. Once again, take your awareness to the support underneath you, all the places your body is supported. Allow your body to sink into that support. And then when you've done that, big breath in, fill up with air all the way to the top of your breath. Feel the support underneath you, and on the exhale, release your body into that support once more. And then take three more breaths just like that. Every exhale, allowing yourself to sink a little deeper, release a little more into that support. And then let the breath come back to its own natural rhythm. Every exhale, starting to notice the soft sound of that exhale without controlling it. Using that exhale to release tension. Every exhale, imagine you can sink a little deeper into that support. You can allow yourself to rest and release more into that calm. Like, imagine that you're on a beach of your choosing, one that you've been on, or one in your imagination, resting, lying on that beach in the blue sky above you, the perfect day for you. Imagining on that beach the smell of the salty air, and then start to tune in to your breath and allow the breath to be the sound of the soft waves coming in and out on the ocean shore. Allowing the exhale.
wash over you like that soft, gentle breeze on the beach. For those of you who'd like to finish your practice, start to notice without looking the surroundings that you're resting in. Feel into the room around you, the support underneath you. Notice your breath. And start to allow that breath to get a little deeper on the inhale. Exhale, maybe out through the mouth like a soft sigh. And allowing that more mindful breath to allow movement to awaken in your body in your own way. Maybe that's very little movement, or maybe you want to stretch wide or long. Maybe your knees drift up towards the sky and you can watch them from side to side, allowing the movements to be yours. There's no particular way of awakening here. Staying as you are. If you're on your back, maybe rolling to one side or the other, taking a beat before you start to draw yourself up to a place that you want to finish your practice. And that may be just where you are. Hands in a gesture of closing, whatever that means for you. Take a breath in all the way to the top of your breath. Soften your gaze on the exhale. Draw your chin down towards your chest. And listen to the sound of that rhythm of your breath. A gentle ocean exhale. Thank yourself for your practice, for listening to yourself, your inner teacher today.